This is TWiT.
Jane, Manhattan Beach is next. Hi, Jane. Leo Laporte, thank you for hanging on.
Hi, Leo.
Hello. Sorry, didn't mean to startle you. How you doing, Jane?
I'm doing well.
Good.
And really like listening to all the people who've talked this morning.
Thank you.
Yes. Let's see. I tried to make notes so I could make sure I remembered everything. I'm inquiring about LastPass or something similar, and I have a gazillion passwords. Of course, all of them have to be different.
Yes.
Yeah, right.
Even I reuse passwords sometimes. You just remember that when you do that, all the sites then are somewhat insecure.
Yes.
So I only do it on things like my newspaper login, things like that, where so what if a bad guy got that? That wouldn't be the end of the world.
I hope. Okay.
Yeah.
So the other part of this is that I'm looking on the LastPass site, and I thought I would get some ideas, like what to look out for. So I cannot find any, well, they've got testimonials, the topic, but it does not open. So my inquiry to you today is, what should I look out for when using LastPass and or a similar one that you might recommend? And I do have another part to that.
Well, first let me say LastPass is a sponsor of many of our shows.
So
I love LastPass. I've used it for 10 years, practically since they started. They only became a sponsor recently, but I've recommended it for all 10 years. But there are many other good similar ideas, the password managers, that's what these are called. The idea is that instead of having to remember passwords, you put them in a secure vault, which is a digital file, but a secure vault. And all you have to remember is the one password that opens the vault. You can even secure it further, which I'd recommend, with two-factor authentication. So you enter the password, but the first time you use a vault on a new device, you'll have to also enter a code that you'll get from your phone. That way, even if a bad guy got the password, he still wouldn't be able to unlock your vault. The vault itself is totally secure, and I would say this is true of all the major players, 1Password, LastPassword. There's KeePass, Dashlane, quite a few of these. I like LastPass because we vetted the software early on with the creator, Joe Segrest, and I think they've kept up. The other reason I use LastPass is it works on every machine I use, Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, even on Linux machines. They have a Chrome browser plugin and so forth. So it makes it very easy for me. When I set up a new machine, one of the first things I set up is LastPass. Now I've got all my passwords available to me to quickly set up. It's not just websites, to set up apps as well with their passwords. So were you asking about best practices with LastPass, or what is your concern, or what issues would you like to know more about?
Well, anything that I put on the internet, I'm concerned about.
Yeah, so remember, LastPass doesn't protect anything but your passwords or what you enter in there. So if you're on a website and you give them a credit card number, LastPass isn't protecting that. It can store the credit card number in LastPass. In fact, I do that. But once you give it to somebody, it's out of LastPass's hands, and unfortunately yours as well. So if you use a credit card on Amazon, for instance, it's used, and Amazon has that. If they were to get broken into, the good news is you could easily reset your password. But once you give a password or credit card or any other information to a site, it's no longer protected. It's only protected, in LastPass so that you can use it. But as soon as you use it, you're telling somebody the password.
Well, and then on LastPass, it is the password that is protected.
Yes, it's stored in LastPass in a secure fashion. So even if somebody could somehow hack into LastPass, they wouldn't be able to get that password. Only you can see that. And not just password. As I said, I use it, and any password manager, this would be the same, to store credit card numbers. I put driver's license and passport images in there. Any social security numbers, anything that I want to remember, but I want to keep safe, I keep in that vault. Think of it as it's like a physical vault. It's a secure vault that only you have access to. But once you take something out of the vault and give it to somebody, LastPass is no longer taking care of it. They do have a nice security checkup feature you might want to run that will go out and say, oh, you're using the same password on these 42 sites. And they even have a system that kind of helps you change those to more secure passwords. The point of a password manager is that not only will it store the passwords, it will help you generate really secure, long passwords. The problem with a secure password is not memorable. If it's memorable, it's not secure.
Yes.
It's totally random. It's a weird combination of letters and numbers and punctuation marks. It's totally random. And it's long. It's more than 8 characters. It's 10, 12, as long as you can make it. 30, 40, 50. The longer you make it, the more secure it is. And so a password manager, password vault, will generate these very long, very strong passwords and then remember them for you. Because no one could. Mr. Memory couldn't remember all of these. So from now on, once you start using a password manager, you should let it generate the passwords and generate a unique one for each site. That's the most secure practice to use. And whenever you can, LastPass doesn't say this, but it is true. If a site offers this thing, do you know what I mean when I say two-factor authentication?
That I have to give 2 pieces of information in order to prove that I'm the person on the account.
A+, gold star, putting that right on your forehead there. that's exactly it. And the 2 pieces of identification usually are in 2 different categories. So there's 3 ways to, it's all about proving you're you, right? What we call identification authentication. And it's something you know, which is a password, something you have, which could be a little dongle, a physical thing. Your phone is something you have. And then something you are, which is your iris or fingerprint scan. Those are the 3 kinds of authentication. 2-factor ideally chooses types from 2 different styles. So a password that's in your head or in your password manager and a 6-digit code generated by an app on your phone. That would be very secure. A bad guy would have to both know your password and then get your phone. Or hack it somehow to get both pieces of information. That makes it more than twice as hard. I guess that's the point. It's not impossible, but it's just really, really hard.
Well, good to have that extra feature on there.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Use it whenever you can is my bottom line there. Yeah.
Definitely, yes. In looking on the site, what it is, it says, yes, there is a free offer.
Yeah.
Then I'm looking further, and all I can find is upgrade to, granted, $2 a month is nominal.
Yeah.
However, I can't find it that would continue with just the...
I think if you just download it and run it, it'll run. It just won't do some of the things you might want to, like, for instance, run on a smartphone. And they'll show you what the premium features are. But that's, to me, the most important premium feature is the ability to run not just on a computer, but everywhere on smartphones, tablets, and computers. And that you do pay for. But as you say, $2 a month is not outrageous. It used to be $1 a month.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, either one would be fine.
I think it just depends if you need it. If there are free password managers, almost always the free password manager is less convenient in some way. For instance, if you use Apple's have built-in password managers on iOS and macOS, but they don't work anywhere but iOS and macOS. So if you ever have to use Windows or an Android phone, they're not very useful. So it's things like that. That, you know, you can get free ones, but they'll be less useful than, I think, a paid one. And if you look at other ones, I mean, LastPass is great. It's what I use, but 1Password is also very good. Dashlane is also very good. Those would be my 3 favorites.
Okay. And you think that doing the next one up, i.e. the $2 a month, is better than getting the free one?
Only if you need those features. So there is a table, I'm sure, somewhere saying, here's what you get when you pay for it.
There is.
Yeah.
Yes.
If you need any of those, pay for it. If not, don't.
Okay. And they'll keep going for as long as I want it?
I hope so. they're a sponsor. Even if you don't pay, the password vault does not go away, just the capability of using it on an Android or iOS phone.
Oh, so they would keep it. And,
yeah.
And then if I continued later on, I would have it.
That's right.
Cool. Okay. Thank you so much for everything today.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I'm really glad you called, Jane, because you're doing the single most important thing you can do to keep yourself secure.
Good.
Okay. I think it's real. I got my mom to do it. All my family members, of course, they all fell off the wagon right away because it's too much trouble. Everybody wants to just use birth date and dog's name for your password. But when you hear about 500 million accounts leaked by Marriott and the passwords leaked, if you use that same password on many sites, all of those sites would be compromised. You would now have to go out and change the password, and you'd have to remember where you used it. That's why a password vault is really, really important. You gotta use one. You gotta. I know it's not as convenient. There is a definite trade-off between convenience and security, but it's not that inconvenient. Err on the side of security.